I am going to go through my bronzers and highlighters today. I also have a face palette and I think I have two face palettes actually. I think. Yes. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And I am a light olive complexion, or I am a light warm olive, which is kind of important in this category and all the other categories as well. Let's start with my cream bronzers and then powder bronzers. So let's start with bronzers. Let's kind of move everything to the side a little bit. Okay, let's start with my cream bronzers. I have three. Yes, I have three. I have the one from e.l.f. in the shade Honey Drip. When I put it on, it's not bad, but it is a little bit, I don't know. We will reserve judgment. Then I have the one from ABH in the shade Amber, which is a very, very warm one. Very warm. As you can see. Yes. I do like the consistency though. And then I have the newest one to the collection, which is from Glam Shop, which is the shade Olive. Okay. That one is staying because it's new. I also have here a few kind of contour sticks. I have one from Max & More. Oh yeah, that's way too pink. So that one is going to go. I have one from NYX in the shade Medium Tan. So let's get this one then. It's too pink, so that one's going to go away as well. Then I have here my KKW stick, which is not going anywhere. This is my basically contour stick. Those are the creams. Yes, so let's see. I think I'm going to keep these three. Well, I know I'm going to keep Glam Shop, but I'm going to keep the other two as well. So I'm keeping three, basically, four, and decluttering three. Two, yes, okay. Then I have some powder bronzers. Let's start with this one from Lethal. This is the shade Tectonic, but it is not a good shade for me, I think. But we will see. We will see. I do love Lethal as a brand though. Let's go to my favorite that I know I'm not getting rid of, which is the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil. Yeah, that one is way prettier on me. So that one, that's the baseline. Glam Shop Olive Bronzer. This one is new. I really do like it. It's a very... I need to build it up. It's a very, very light bronzer. But when I put it on, it's very, very pretty. We see the color. It's a very, very sheer bronzer. It's new, it's staying. Then we have the other one, which is chocolate olive, which is darker. And way more cool toned. So let's put that against the Bahama Mama. Yeah, Bahama Mama is a little bit too red for me. So I'm actually going to declutter that one. Because it is just, when I put it on, it's a little bit muddy on me. And I can kind of see why it has a little bit too much pink in it. Yes, that one's staying as well. Then we have here Ofra River. River is, I kept it last time, but it is way too neutral for me. Can you see that? Yeah, I'm getting rid of that. And then I have CXC Beauty, the Olive 2. Let's put you here. Which is a warm olive, which is also a nice shade on me. I just have to be a little bit more careful. So that one I am keeping as well. Then the last thing that I have here is from Kaleidos. Yeah, I can already tell that this is way too pink for me. So that one is going too. And this was the warm and medium. I think I have somewhere the... that's on there. I don't think so. No. I thought I had somewhere the pack for the Lethal shade. I thought I still had that one. But yeah, I'm going to declutter the Lethal bronzer. Let's go to highlighters then. I actually should have done this one in the previous video because I kind of use it as a blush topper hybrid. It is in my... in between my highlighters. Oh yeah, this is not going anywhere. This queen, it's not going anywhere. I just wanted to show you that I did not forget that I had it. Let's go to my cream highlighters. These two from ColourPop are staying. This is the shade Wisp. I'm going to pan this. This is my favorite shade. I think it's just so, so stunning. This is a little bit of a yellower one. And then I have the shade, I think it's Happy Thoughts, which is more almost rose gold. Both look stunning on me. And I prefer a highlighter that is a hint. I don't want to say too dark, but I don't like an icy highlighter. Let's just say that. So both are staying, which I knew that they would. This one from AOA Studios. It's pretty, but it's not my preferred formula. So this one is going. Then let's go to this one, which is my Duolite Highlight Palette from BH Cosmetics. I don't think it's available anymore. This is actually a new one. This is staying because I really like to pull that in with different eye looks. That's also why I don't need an all shimmer palette, for instance, because I have the one from BH Cosmetics. Okay. Let's go to this one. This is from Revolution Pro. It's their Skin Finish in Opalescent. I use this so, so much, but I haven't touched it in quite some time. It's a very, very pretty skin finish though. And I could also use this as a highlighter, but I just don't. So I'm just going to actually toss this because it's broken, it's older, and yeah. Okay, let's go to this one, which is from Becca, which is Own Your Light. This is my favorite. This is not going anywhere, even though Becca's out of business. This is just such a stunning highlighter. It's staying. Then we have DJ's Boutique. I love this one. This is actually on my desk. I use this so, so much. This is the shade Heatwave. It's a loose highlighter, but it is stunning. It is stunning for all. Because there are so many different shifts in here. It's just so pretty. Now I can see that the one from Becca is more pink on me because it eats my skin eats up the green. But here it's just, this one is more, it's more of an orangey one. It's just so stunning. I love to use this highlighter. And it's very, very easy to use as well. So it's not going anywhere. Then I have Catrice. Is that the only one from Catrice? Yeah, this is the shade Beyond Golden Glow. If you like a blinding highlighter, if you like the Ofra highlighter formula, but you want something cheaper, the ones from Catrice are definitely the way to go. Look how blinding that is. It is a tad too icy for me though, for what I like. I am keeping it because I like to have a Catrice option in my collection. Then we have here Essence, the highlighter in the shade Mesmerizing. And this is a more subtle highlighter. Also very, very pretty. It's a little bit too light for me though, so I'm getting rid of this one. Then we have here from e.l.f. This is the Multidimensional Face and Body Shimmer from their Paradise collection. I got this as a gift. This is also very, very pretty. It's almost more along the lines of a topper though. But it's very, very pretty. I haven't tried it. I haven't touched it in a long time though. It's going in the maybe. Yes, because I do really like it. Then I have here the shade Strobe from X Revolution, which is also very, very pretty. This is more along the lines of what I like color-wise. So I think I'm actually going to get rid of the one from Catrice because it's just too yellow. And I think this is a prettier color. So that one, the shade Strobe, is staying. Then I have two from Bitter Lace Beauty. I got these as a gift. So this is the shade Life is Bubbles. And here is Happily Ever After. So these are very, They are stunning. Very, very nice and shiny. This one has a hint of blue in it, which is very interesting. Very pretty. So both, yeah, both are staying. Okay. Then I have the Divine Highlighter from V Cosmetics. It's the only highlighter that she has and the only highlighter that I have from her. It is also a multi, can you see? I don't know if you can see, but it's also a multi-colored one. So this is a little bit more of a greener one. I really do like it and it is staying. I don't know how much I will declutter in my highlighter. Here's another loose one from Madage Beauty London. This is not a highlighter, but I used it as a highlighter because it was just so pretty as a highlighter. I use this a lot in summer because it was just very, very pretty to dust over my cheeks. So it's staying. I can also use it for my nails and you can use it as a loose eyeshadow as well if you want to. Then I have, let's go to these two from Ofra. This is the mini Rodeo Drive. I've wanted Rodeo Drive for forever. And I have it here. I really love the color as well. I think that the color is prettier on me than the one from Catrice. So Rodeo Drive is staying as well. And then here is the shade Bali. Oh, this is also so pretty. I don't have any room left. Let's go here. It's stunning. Can you see it? I don't know if you can. But it's just so, so pretty. So this one is staying as well. Then I have two from Makeup Revolution and the Sof collab. I have the shade Cookies and Cream. And I have Honey Glaze. Honey Glaze I needed because it had the word honey in it. That was the reason. These are also very, very pretty. It's way too dark. So usually I mix. So basically, usually I kind of do this if I use it. I go back and forth with my brush. It's stunning. But you know what? I'm going to give this to someone else. Clean finger. This is a little bit more along the lines of the color that I like. And then if I mix them... I think it's a very, very nice quality, this. I think it is stunning. I don't grab it. And no, I'm going to pass this one along as well. Then I have two here from Nomad Cosmetics. This was my, I think it was my second PR. I'm actually not sure. The one that I love the most is this one. This one I think is just stunning. I will put it here. I love to use this one as a blush top. This one I actually don't really use. I wanted to keep the collection together, but I think it is time that I get rid of this one, which is the shade Hot Shot, just because I don't use a highlight color like this ever. So this one though, I really do love. So this one I'm keeping. And then I have here a few left. This is from Unique Beauty in the shade Mavu. I think this is a stunning shade. I got this in PR, but it's a stunning shade and it's also for me very complimentary. This one is staying. I have here Ray Rider and Mars Melter from Kaleidos. Yeah, they are staying. Both are staying. I think that I'm getting rid of this one. Just because it is such a sparkly topper. But looking at what I'm keeping, I'm going to pass this one along as well. So I have a very, very nice and shiny sparkly arm. So this is what I'm getting rid of. And this is what I'm keeping. I don't feel I have a lot of true dupes. So yeah, what I'm keeping, I'm happy with. So let me... Count. Let me count how many I'm getting rid of. Let's start with the bronzers. One. Okay, three. Four. So I'm getting rid of four bronzers. Yes. Well, and two bronzer sticks. Yeah. Then highlighters is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 highlighters I'm getting rid of. And 7 bronzer things. And the rest I'm keeping, which is most, but that is okay. I'm happy with that. This was it for today. Let me know if you have any of these. Let me know some of your favorites. And if you want to see the other videos in this collection, there is a playlist. And if you have already seen them, make sure you are subscribed for the next ones. Because what do I have left to declutter? Lippies? And eyeshadow palettes, I think. I think that's it. Maybe I will go through my eye pencils as well. I think I need to, actually. But I don't know how interesting that is to see. I will film it and I will upload it. And we will see how you guys will like it. And then this is it for me. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day. Fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye.